morning, students. Okay, today I am going to continue the social, and this is the first chapter. In the first chapter, as well, I have done the have completed the off lesson from this, and I am continuing the same chapter today. Okay, in the previous class we have learnt about the what are the sources. Okay, the sources, how many types we have? In sources we have namely two types, that is literary source and literary source and the archaeological sources. In literary source, again it has been divided into two, that is written literature and the oral literature. Okay, in written literature again we have two types, that is native literature and the foreign literature. And next is about the oral literature also we have learned. Okay, we have completed the first sources, that is about the literary source. Now we are going to learn about the archaeological sources. Second one is what? Archaeological sources. Okay, what do you mean by archaeological sources? Okay, again this archaeological sources has been divided into four types. That there are what? In the first one is inscriptions. Inscriptions. And second is coins. Third is monuments. Fourth is other ruins. Okay, these are the four archaeological sources. First is about the, we will learn about the archaeological sources, and next about the other types. Archaeological sources are available not only on the surface of the earth but also hidden deep in the depths of the earth. The hidden things in the earth are dug out by using scientific methods. This process is called as excavation. Harappan civilization came to light only due to the process of excavation. During excavation, ruins of buildings, inscriptions, coins, terracotta pieces, bangles, seals, beads, bone pieces, metal and other have been found. These are analyzed by applying various scientific methods to understand the people, understand the life of people of those times. Okay, what do you mean by archaeological source? Means these are the sources which are available either on, not only on the surface of the earth but also the deep under the, buried under the earth also. Okay, some of the hidden things in the earth dug, they are being dug out and using the scientific methods. This process is called what? Excavation. Means searching of a sources by scientific method is called what? Excavation. Harappan civilization also came to light only due to this excavation. During excavation, ruins of buildings, means the ruins of building means it may be old fallen buildings, okay, which is buried under the earth. And also the inscriptions, coins. Inscription means written records. It may be on the walls or it may be on the rocks or pillars. And also the coins, on the time which type of coins they used to use. Terracotta pieces means they are the pieces of a cloth. Bangles. Okay, on the time they are not only made with the glass bangles, but they have used to made that with the mud and some of the metals also they used to make bangles. Seals means it. How we use the seals in schools and other government officials, you know, some of the seals also present on that time. Beads, bone pieces of, it may be animals, human beings also, metals also, and other have been found. These are analyzed by applying various scientific methods. How these are available? Okay, these are available by applying the various scientific methods. To understand the life of people, to understand how the people has to live their life at those times. Next, now in this we have to go, we are going to learn about the inscription. Inscription means engraved writing. Inscriptions are written on stone, rock, metal, ivory, terracotta and other metal that last longer. Ok, Okay, I said no, before the inscription or the written records, it may be on the stone, rock, metal or the ivory. Ivory means, you know, the teeth of elephant. Ivory, white color teeth has, or no, that is called what? Ivory. Some of the inscriptions are written on that also. Terricot means it is the cloth and other materials which have the very long life. Inscription are made reliable as they have a direct relation with these events. Okay, from that inscription you come to know that there will be what are the things that happened on the time. Means we have the direct relation for that. Ashoka's inscription are the earliest inscription found in India. Okay, Ashoka's also there is there. Ashoka Chakravarti have no. Okay, his inscriptions also found in India earlier days. Most of these inscriptions are Brahmi scripts. Okay, most of the inscriptions are in the Brahmi scripts. Their language is Prakrit. Okay, how we use now Kannada, Hindi, Telugu, English as the language on the time they used to speak in the Prakrit languages. Thousands of inscriptions are found in Karnataka. Thousands of inscriptions are found in Kannada, Telugu, Tamil, Sanskrit, Prakrit languages also. Samudragupta's Allahabad pillar inscription in Samudragupta, there is a pillar in Allahabad, that is Samudragupta's inscriptions are written on that. Imadi Pulakeshi, Ayyavala inscriptions. Paravellus, Hatti Gumba inscriptions and other inscriptions portray the military achievements of then rulers. Okay, on that rulers and pillars, on that pillars we can see that what are the achievements they have in the field of military. Okay, achievements of the rulers also they have mentioned in that. The Uttara Meruru inscription narrate the ruler administration of Chola kings. In Uttara Meruru there is a inscription in that we can come to know the how the King Cholas have been ruled. Apart from this, many political, social, cultural, economic, educational, religious aspects are reflected in this inscription. Along with this, it mentions so many political life, social, cultural and economic educations also they have mentioned in this inscriptions. And religious aspects, in religions, how they believe. And reflects in this inscription. This is the inscription you can see in the textbook. Okay, aside they have written some of the inscription on the pillar and also the bark of a plant. This is about the inscription. Okay, when you come to the coins. Now also we are using coins, no 5 rupee coins, 10 rupee coins. Before they used to use the Nagane, Entane, Eradane. Some of the different coins they used to use on that time. Okay. Though the coins are small in shape, they contain many important aspects. Okay, you can see in the pictures. These are all the coins. Whereas these coins are small, but they include many important aspects itself. They are helpful in understanding the geographical extent of the ruler's kingdom who maintained the coins. Already it has a very small coins, but from that we can come to know more things, that is how geographical future and understanding, helpful in understanding the geographical extent to the rulers to kingdom who minted the coins also. They also aid us in knowing the language of administration. By this we come to know that what are the language they used to read out in that time. We come to know from these coins, titles that the kings possessed their religion. Okay, and there are some of the titles also they have mentioned on these coins, and about the religion also they have mentioned in this. Economic conditions of the times. Okay, and mental technology in voyage of the particular kingdoms. Samudragupta had minted 7 different types of gold coins. Okay, Samudragupta has minted means where the place where they are preparing the coins. The preparing of coins is called what? A mint. Okay. Samudragupta has minted 7 different coins, types of gold coins. Based on the picture of those coins, it is said that Samudragupta was a lover of music. Okay, in different coins, picture on this coin. So by knowing the coin, we come to know that Samudragupta is a great lover of the music.
For the
education. Okay, Nalanda at that time it is a very famous university. The fort of Sri Lanka Patna explains the accomplishment in area of defense technology. Okay, the fort of Sri Lanka Patna explains how the defense means defense force means we know that defense law under time which are the equipments they used to use in the time of war. Okay, we'll come to them. We'll come to that which are the techniques they used to use and which are the equipments they have used on that time. Does the monument throw light on them? Contemporary religious aspects, technology, economic growth, scientific knowledge and creativity achieved. Okay, by this monuments what will come to know about the technology and religious aspects, means how they are worshipping the God, it may be the different religions and technology also. Economic growth, what was the economic position of the people? Okay, in some kingdoms they used to use the gold coins. Okay, means how they are prosperous. And scientific knowledge also and creativity achieved also. This is about the monuments. Next come to the other use. Means what, which are the other archaeological sources are found rather than these mountain coins, monuments, coins and inscriptions. Based on the various pieces of teleport, bangles, beads and the seal produces procured during the examination, one can understand the socio-cultural, economic, political and religious life of them. Of them people. Not only this, no, one can also understand the food habits and patterns of the business of those times by applying carbon 14 dating procedures on the biological ruins, dead animals, birds and trees also. Found in these sites, one can arrive at the accurate period of the ruins. Buddha stupas came to light during the excavation of Sanathi in Yadagiri district and Rajagata and of Doddaballapura taluk. In the excavations conducted at Arkemedu and Pattanam in Tamil Nadu, a large number of evidences were found that speak of commercial contact between South India and the Romans. Like this, the remains found at excavation till many things that were lost over a period of time. Okay, what are the other resources? Means some of the bangles and record pieces, means cloth pieces, beads and seals also procured the procured during the examination. One can understand the, by this we can understand the social, cultural, economic, personal, religious life of the people. Not only this, one can understand the food habits and the patterns of the business. Okay, by this we come to know about the food habits of those people and also the what are the business activities of in the times. By applying carbon 14 dating procedure on the biological rules, by applying the, that is it, what by carbon dating means, we are testing the carbon. Okay, which type of carbon is present in that, by that we will come to know that how many years back it has been existed. Okay, and what are the things it has been eaten. But on the biological species, dead animals which are found in the buried under the earth and also the birds, trees also found in these sites. One can arrive to the accurate period of the risk. By this we come to the how many years it has been destroyed, how many years time it has been destroyed and what time it has been present. Buddha stupa came to light during the excavation at Sanathi in Yadagiri, Buddha's Yadagiri districts. Okay, Buddha stupa came to existence when there was excavation during the excavation at Sanathi in Yadagiri district and Rajagata of Doddaballapura taluk. In Rajagata also is a place where the excavation was done. In that also so many sources we got there. In the excavation conducted at Arkemedu and Pattanam in Tamil Nadu. Okay, in Arkemedu and Pattanam, it is in Tamil Nadu. There also the large number of evidence are found there and speak of commercial contact. By that evidence will come to know that the commercial contact between the business deals between the South India and the so many Roman countries. like this remains found at excavation till many things that will last over a period of time, and so many evidence also present here the what is the excavation time, but they have been destroyed because of the past so many years. Okay, this completes your first chapter in social about the sources. Okay, in this they have given only question answers. So our question answers are scientific. Okay, question answers are sent in the WhatsApp, and you have to read the lesson everything. Means you have to learn what you mean by native literature, what you mean by first understand all the things. If you have any doubts regarding this lesson, call the students. Okay, first I send the notes for you today. Thank you, students.